Hi folks, we are one more episode of the Supply Chain Show. Again, pleasure to have Richard. Today we will talk about the procurement or purchasing function in SMEs.
Right.
You know, why it is different, what is the journey, again, who is better than Richard, who works with a lot of SMEs anyway, and I think you've been consulting as well. So welcome to the show, Richard.
Thanks, again, good to see you.
Quick introduction, please.
Delighted, I'm Richard Beaumont. I work for myself with a mix of, in fact, SMEs and large companies, but focusing on procurement as well as training and development, and that's off the back of working as Chief Procurement Officer at Co-op Bank, some time as VP Procurement at Rolls-Royce and with McKinsey before that.
Good. Right, so I think let's start with what defines SME, right, and how does it look like, again, thinking about both EU and UK and EU definition.
Okay, well, it might amuse you at a time of doing Brexit that I would come back to the EU definition of what an SME is, but actually I think it's really useful. So micro business, 10 people, 2 million turnover, small business, you know, 50 people, 10 million turnover, and then all the way up to a medium-sized business, 250 people, 50 million turnover. And if we think about the UK, that's 99% of businesses in the UK
99.
Are an SME.
Wow.
So this is an important area, right?
No, perfect. So I think I work with for SME for a while.
Yeah.
And for them, because the typical state of SME is people have multi-head roles, right?
Yeah.
So you are also a buyer, you're a planner, you are placing purchase order as well,
you're
putting production order as well. And you don't really think about the typical, as if you work for a big company, that I'm a commodity manager, my job is to manage steel, or my job is to manage plastics and all that.
You don't think
like that, right?
Yeah.
And so what I want to know is, but again, as a business grow, the procurement or operation procurement should become a procurement instead of procurement function.
Right.
So I want to learn about that journey and what should be the let's call it the SME owners, the 99% of them, what they should do.
Do you know what? I think you hit the key word there, which is journey.
Yeah.
So if let's be honest, right? If you're starting a business, maybe you're one or two employees, you know, you're in that micro business category, do you have a procurement function? Of course you don't. It's going to be the MD owner who is doing all of the buying. And that's important because they are as close as you can be to it. They understand the suppliers, they understand the product, they have the intimate knowledge of the risks and the supply chain challenges that come. And do you know what? It works pretty well. They don't need systems or processes. They don't need great big P2P systems or contracts. They just don't need it. They can just run it. The trick is that a successful micro business is going to become a small business, is going to become a medium-sized enterprise.
Yeah.
And do you know what? In that journey, by the time you're a medium-sized enterprise, the MD isn't close to it. They're not running it day to day. And therefore, they've got to think about what is the kind of procurement function they need as their business grows.
Okay. So once the business grows, right?
Yeah.
The spend is growing right now.
Yeah.
Right? So they have to have this, I would like to think, a building blocks
when
they were small.
So right.
They become a medium-sized company. They have the, let's call it, whatever the building blocks are, really.
Yep.
So can you explain what would the building blocks would be?
Yeah, absolutely. So it is the same fundamental building blocks that exist in multi-billion multinational companies, right? Which is that there is control and management of spend. There is control and management of contracts. There is risk management, there is relationship management, and there is effective process. And those are the same, whether you are one person and £100 of turnover, or a million people and £1 billion of turnover, it doesn't matter. The challenge is how best to execute and realizing when you need to start to develop capability in those things.
That was the question actually I want to ask. So now you have the building block, but you have to acquire people with that level of skills, right? So what should you do? You should develop the existing people to that level or also acquire as well? What is the best practice?
Great question. So, I mean, this kind of touches on that old chestnut, if you like, of, you know, are you better off getting a procurement person and teaching them the category, or get a category person and teach them procurement? The truth is, if you're going from a micro to a small business, the chances are someone in the organization is going to gravitate towards running procurement.
Yeah.
And actually, they're not just going to do procurement, they're probably also going to run the supply chain as well.
Yeah.
So, in truth, if you've identified that person in your business because they understand your business, it's actually more about thinking about equipping them with some training, but also with the first steps into systems and processes. And for me, I'd kind of focus on training people on risk management, focusing on relationship management, but also beginning to get contracts under control and spend under control. Because if you can see those two things, actually you can manage the rest.
Again, I was going to ask, I think we are going to, as we're doing this interview early part of August, the Brexit is looming around.
Brexit.
I would expect there must be some impact. So what's your advice? Because I'm confused, right? So I'm sure not many people are.
I'm pretty certain that everybody in the UK is confused and in Europe. And actually, do you know, if you're an SME now, you've got about 10 weeks, okay, before, you know, we might have a no deal. And, you know, my challenge, my suggestion is, do you know whether you're affected or not? And there's a simple way to determine this. Go and look at your suppliers and ask yourselves, are they in the same country as you, or are you coming across the border from Europe? And once you've checked your big suppliers, go and have a conversation with them about where they get their supply from. So getting down to that second tier. Because if you discover that either the large part of your suppliers or their suppliers could be affected by tariffs in the event of a no-deal Brexit, now is the time. It's late, but that's not our fault. But now is the time to start thinking about, could I use a different supplier, or could I do something about it? And to, while big businesses have thought about this, actually for SMEs, you really need to look at this now. And if you want a hand with that, well, give me a call.
Yeah, and again, give Richard a call, right? Because I think you're working with some businesses already. Right, and I think you should have a right to.
Yeah, and it's a problem for them.
It's a problem for them as well. No, again, Richard, thank you for your time. As always, great learning experience for talking to you.
Perfect.
I'm sure that the audience like it as well. And hopefully we meet again. Thank you for your time.
Appreciate it. Take care, everyone.
I aim to do knowledge videos and interviews with procurement and supply chain professionals and leaders. Consider subscribing to this channel. And I have written practical guides on supply chain. See the link below.